Hey kids, today we're making a black velvet cake that we're gonna decorate as a spider web for Halloween.
It's cooking and crafting, yeah, cooking and crafting. It's YouTube's best for creative things, it's cooking and crafting.
In a medium-sized bowl, we're gonna put in 2.5 cups of cake flour. If you don't have cake flour, I have a substitute recipe up where you can make your own and not have to run out and go buy a box of this stuff. And then we're gonna add in a teaspoon of salt and a 1/4 cup of chocolate. I don't have it together today, I'm sorry. So here's our 1/4 cup of baking cocoa, you know. And here's the teaspoon of the salt. And we're gonna mix this up and we're gonna set this on the side and get our liquidy stuff together. We're gonna add 1.5 cups of sugar to 1.5 cups of canola or vegetable oil, whatever your poison is. And we are going to combine this on medium speed until it's well combined. And at that point, I'm going to add in 2 eggs that have been brought to room temperature, 1 at a time. I'm gonna add in, it says 1 tablespoon of black food coloring, but I'm using the Wilton food coloring, so I don't really know that I really would need that much, but I'm just gonna go ahead and add about that equivalent. I'm just using a plastic fork because that way I can just throw it away and not have to worry about it getting everywhere. And to that, I'm gonna close this. I guess I should show you. Black icing coloring. And then to that we are also going to add 1 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract. I use vanilla paste, so it will seem a lot thicker. And that's it with that bottle. On to the next. I'm going to go ahead and mix this up. And once this is fully combined, I'm going to add my flour mixture that we've already prepared and put to the side. And I'm gonna alternate it with 1 cup of buttermilk. So just little bits of each until everything is combined. Look at that beautiful black. Isn't that awesome? Yeehaw! All right. Let's put in a little bit of this flour. And we'll just continue on alternating with the buttermilk. And when I have that all totally completed, we'll be back. In this little bowl here, I have 1.5 teaspoons of baking soda and 2 teaspoons of white vinegar. And when you add it in together, it foams up quite nicely. And I'm just gonna go ahead and beat this into here for a few seconds. Just wanna make sure that it gets in there nice and good. I have my oven preheating to 350 degrees and I'm going to get my pans ready. Now I have 9-inch pans. They're supposed to be 8-inch pans. I need to purchase some 8-inch pans to tell you the truth. I'm gonna just spray this with Pam spray. I'll be right back. These are gonna go into the oven for 30 to 35 minutes. I'm gonna level off the cakes and I'm mixing up a buttercream frosting. I will put the link at the end of the video that you can click to. And then we're gonna decorate this cake for Halloween. I have this ready-made black decorating icing from Wilton that came with a little, you know, a little tip there. And it's a little thicker than I would really like it to be, but we're just going to continue drawing circles around, and then we're going to drag that barbecue stick through it to create our spider web. I'm hoping it's going to work. Do you think it'll work? Okay. Oh, it's so thick that it doesn't give me a nice, firm line. Yeah, sweetheart. Okay. So here it goes. Yeah. Not as good as I wished it to be, but good enough, I guess.
Thank you for watching Cooking and Crafting. Before we have to say goodbye, make sure